special guests. I'm Sharna Waldron, and I seek your endorsement to be the Republican nominee for Minnesota's 4th Congressional District. I want to thank my friends for their kind words of support this morning. This afternoon already, the day's gone so quickly. Joe Schultz, he's doing tremendous work each and every day managing my campaign. Joe Salmon's support and encouragement is truly second to none. We all owe Michelle Mankey a debt of gratitude for her service to CD4. And I know we all appreciate having Roger Chamberlain's fiscally conservative voice in the Minnesota Senate, and I appreciate the wise advice he shared with me. I want to thank my wonderful husband, Russ, for his very kind words about who I am as a person, and for his willingness to share his talent with us all this morning by singing the national anthem. I always love to hear him sing. And I'm deeply grateful for his support, and I'm fortunate to be sharing my life's journey with him. As some of you may know, I was born and raised on the east side of St. Paul. In fact, I've lived my entire life in CD4. I attended Harding High School and went to the University of Minnesota, where I graduated with a degree in economics. I then spent some time working for Senator Rudy Boschwitz in Washington, D.C. I know I speak for all of us here when I thank the Senator for his service to the people of Minnesota. I returned to the Twin Cities to attend the University of Minnesota Law School and spent the next 20 years, how time flies, working in the private sector. Ladies and gentlemen, when was the last time Betty McCollum worked in the private sector? High school? At any rate, I focus much of my legal practice on patent matters, helping entrepreneurs turn their dreams into reality. They solved all sorts of problems and created fantastic new products. My friends, I know firsthand what hardworking, creative, energetic Americans in the private sector can do when what happens? When the government gets out of the way. Out of our way. New ideas, new products, and new services come to the market, not just here, but around the world, when the American economy works as it should. Unfortunately, as those of us gathered here today know all too well, the current administration and its yes woman, Betty McCollum, have created conditions where our creative energies are stymied and our entrepreneurial spirit is blocked in each and every way. I live in Maplewood now, near 3M, where my husband works. Russ and I have been married for 18 years, and we're blessed with a close-knit and extended family, including 12 nieces and nephews, who fill our lives with sports and music, school activities, and joy. We've been involved and active in this wonderful community for a long time, but recently I realized that more is required if we are going to change the course our country is on. I thought to myself, who represents me in Congress? Who represents my values and aspirations? Who represents my community's priorities? Intrigued, because I could not answer those questions, I began to dig into Betty McCollum's record. And what I found was a far left mess. It became clear to me that Betty votes with the far left out of the mainstream special interests in Washington, D.C. But then, every 2 years, like clockwork, she comes back to Minnesota and runs in our district, holding herself out as some sort of Minnesota moderate. She is no such thing. She simply does not represent the values of the vast majority of us here in CD4. This is why I am asking for your vote for today's endorsements. I have several very clear goals that I want to share with you. Clarity is essential in any leader, and I want you to know what I will work tirelessly on should I earn your trust, your vote, and your endorsement today. first. We must stop our out-of-control spending. I will work tenaciously for a balanced budget and to get our finances in order. We all must deal with individual or family budgets, and the U.S. government should not be any different. Second, we need good jobs and a thriving middle class. We must stop taxing the American people to death. A host of taxes and regulatory costs are strangling our once vibrant middle class. Did you see the Drudge Report earlier this week? We learned that America's middle class is no longer the world's wealthiest. This is a tragedy and a heartache. It can, however, be reversed, and we can start that process by electing me and defeating Betty this November. Third, we need to get Washington out of our way so we can better solve our own problems here in Minnesota. That would be both more effective and less expensive. It's not either or, my friends. It is both better and less expensive to address many important issues, such as education and healthcare, locally, rather than with new programs or policies imposed from Washington. I took a leave of absence from my law practice last year in order to focus on this race. I have to be honest. More than one political observer has told me that we in CD4 run the same race against Betty every 2 years with the same predictable results. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to give notice to you, to the voters of CD4, and to Betty. Not this time. Giving the entire game away, I can reassure you that my team and I have in place a thoughtful plan to raise substantial money for my race. We can't win without serious money. We will have it. I also have a message of fiscal responsibility that will strike a chord with our friends and neighbors throughout the district. Voters don't want their representative in Congress to simply issue blank checks that the establishment can fill in at any time and in any amount, and use on a whim. They want a real voice. They want real representation, and I will deliver it. I also have the muscle that all successful campaigns need, a strong, well-organized volunteer ground game, prepared to deliver my message and get out the voters in support of my campaign. We have to do things differently if we want to win, and my campaign has already begun in this regard. Smart, focused, and effective. Our efforts are directed not only to identifying current supporters, but more importantly, inspiring new ones. This won't be the same race that has been run in CD4 before. The stakes are simply too high. This November is simply too important. Me. Ladies and gentlemen, do you think Betty can get away with that ridiculous slogan that I am part of a so-called war on women? I assure you, she cannot and will not. We know a strong economy is the best friend any woman has, single or married. We know that women don't want government dependency, but want to live their lives free from the grasping claws of those in government who claim to know better. They do not know better. I'm going to let you in on a little secret here today. If I am your endorsed candidate, I will challenge Betty McCollum to not one, but three debates. And these debates will not be hosted by so-called neutral groups, which in fact support her agenda. No, these will be by four neutral groups where Betty will have to defend her deplorable record and answer real questions from you and from me. Thank you so very much for allowing me the opportunity to speak before you today. I'm Sharna Waldron, and I sincerely ask for your vote for endorsement so together we can unseat Betty McCollum. It's time for a new voice, for real representation in Washington. I will work hard every day on your behalf, and with your help, we can win this November.
Thank you very much. Okay, we have